Hello Internet, this is Oscar Lise, back again with another video on root finding, this time a hybrid of Newton's method and bisection. This video assumes that you have some familiarity with bisection and Newton's method, and I recommend watching my videos on these topics. I've also made another video discussing Brent's method, which is a hybrid of IQI, secant, and bisection, which might be helpful to understand this video. It was on that video that somebody asked if I knew anything about a method which mixed bisection and Newton's method, to which I did look into. I did some digging and found slides from Mark Siegelman discussing a method that he called Newt-Safe. He also referenced a book called Numerical Recipes, which I found at my library. This book also referenced another book called Numerical Methods That Work. This is my library's copy of that book. In it, they write, "While Newton-Raphson's global convergence properties are poor, it is fairly easy to design a fail-safe routine that utilizes a combination of bisection and Newton-Raphson. The hybrid algorithm takes a bisection step whenever Newton-Raphson would take a solution out of bounds, or whenever Newton-Raphson is not reducing the size of the brackets rapidly enough." And this is my library's copy of Numerical Methods That Work by Foreman S. Acton. You'll notice that the cover also has the word usually, and that my library has three more copies of this book. Acton writes, "We see that we are in trouble if f prime of x is 0, or even if it is small. In any automatic computer application of Newton's method, we must be sure to check the size of the step we are about to take. Reject it if it is improbably large. Such a rejection could call for an automatic switch to a less sensitive algorithm, like bisection. Or it might merely print out the values of the function and its derivative, in effect, yelling for help, but it should never quietly take the giant step and thereby create a mess for somebody else to clean up." Let's use the arctangent as an example for Newton's method. Folks will recognize this same example from my video on Newton's method interval of convergence. If we use a starting value of 1, Newton's method converges to the root in about 5 iterations. But if we start the value 1.5, this causes Newton's method to diverge. You could also get really unlucky and choose a starting point which causes it to loop infinitely. There's another issue with Newton's method that could happen, and allow me to quote myself from an earlier video.
"If the point that you get has a slope of 0, then you'll never know where to calculate your next x."
Let's look at one final problem of Newton's method, given the function y is equal to x minus 1.75 to the quantity cubed. Let's zoom in a little bit on the root. A little more. Newton's method has a hard time as you get closer and closer to the roots of very flat functions. For example, these points, 1.7, 1.717, 1.728, are taking very small steps to get to the next point. To recap the problems with Newton's method, we can diverge, get stuck in an infinite loop, divide by 0, or have issues with root multiplicity. The answer for our hybrid method is to simply switch to bisection whenever this happens. Newt-Safe says to start with an interval AB, where the function has different signs at A and B, so therefore the root must be between them. Then, compute a starting point of x equal to a plus b over 2. Afterwards, check to see if f of x is less than some epsilon absolute value. If it is, this is a root, and we can stop. Otherwise, check to make sure we're not going to end up dividing by 0. When we are, we'll force a bisection and then restart. Otherwise, when we're safe to divide, we'll go ahead and use Newton's method, and check to make sure that our new step is inside of our boundaries. When it isn't, we'll do bisection again. Otherwise, we'll simply shrink the boundary and then restart the process. For this first Newt-Safe example, let's use the arctangent function from earlier and specify the interval of negative 1, 4. This means our starting point, x, is a plus b over 2, which is the value of 1.5. If we do Newton's method, we'll end up going outside of our boundary. Therefore, we'll force a bisection, giving us a new interval, a, b, and we can restart the process. In this example, let's use a smaller interval of negative 1, 3, giving us our starting x value of 1. When we apply Newton's method, we'll get a point that is inside the boundary, giving us our new value for x. Now we have to check our signs to shrink our boundary. In this case, we'll move a over. Then using the x from earlier, we'll compute our next x and then check the signs to shrink the boundary. Repeat this process until a meets b or we end up converging on the root. There are still a few more things we need to do for Newt-Safe. The first is that whenever we do a bisection, check our interval AB to make sure it's still valid. The second, recall our quote from earlier. The hybrid algorithm takes a bisection step whenever Newton's method would take the solution out of bounds, or whenever Newton's method is not reducing the size of the brackets rapidly enough. Checking the bounds is easy enough with this condition here, but what about that reducing the size of the brackets rapidly enough part? Numerical Recipes gives this condition, saying if f of x times 2 in absolute value is greater than delta x times f prime at x in absolute value, then we'll force a bisection, where delta x is simply our change in step. But what does this condition mean? Let's take a closer look at this condition. Recall Newton's method. If we make one change and subtract x sub n from both sides, we can get this form for Newton's method. Then, if we only care about the magnitude of these values, we can do the absolute value of both sides. This gives us a new equation for delta x. Using what we know now for delta x, we can replace part of that condition with the absolute value of f of x sub n divided by the derivative of f of x sub n. When we multiply it by the derivative of f of x sub n plus 1, as n increases, these derivatives shouldn't change very much, so we get approximately the absolute value of f of x sub n. This means our condition is actually saying if our function at our new point times 2 in absolute value is greater than our function at our old point in absolute value, then it's not converging fast enough. Using what we know now about reducing bracket size, let's compare this to how Newton's method behaved for the function earlier of x minus 1.75 quantity cubed. It takes about 9 iterations for this to converge. With Newt-Safe from the same starting point of 1.5, using the interval 1, 2, we do one iteration of Newton's method, then the next iteration will cause it to go too slow, and therefore we'll force a bisection. This gives us a new starting value for Newt-Safe, which we then use in the next iteration of Newton's method. Then the next step would actually cause us to go too slow again, so we force another bisection, giving us our root. If we include the two bisection steps, we actually save 2 iterations using Newt-Safe. Here are some other variations that you can make to Newt-Safe. First, you could try starting without an interval, or just a single starting point, and use Newton's method or damp Newton's method until the function changes sign, at which case you would have an interval AB. The problem is that you still have all the problems of Newton's method, so maybe this isn't such a great way to go. You could also allow an interval that has the same sign and just iterate until it changes sign like earlier, but if our function is something like y equals x minus 1.75 quantity squared, then it'll never change sign, at which point you could just use an extremum finding algorithm to find a minimum or maximum. You could replace Newton's method in Newt-Safe to create other hybrid methods. For example, if you can compute the second derivative, then you might use Halley's method to make a method called Hal-Safe. Or if you can compute even higher derivatives, then Householder's method to make House-Safe. What if f is a polynomial, in which case you can use Horner's method to create Horn-Safe. But what if you don't have a derivative at all? Then you might consider using Stephenson's method to create Steph-Safe. Or a hybrid between secant and bisection gives you Decker's method, which I have a video on, as well as IQI, secant, and bisection to create Brent's method. It is important to note that Newt-Safe will give you guaranteed convergence. When Newton's method might diverge, switching to bisection would force it to converge, at least linearly. Although note that switching to bisection could speed up convergence when Newton's method is behaving poorly. None of the sources that I looked at proved the order of convergence, so I'll leave this as an exercise for the viewer, although note it's likely quadratic. The code that I used for this video will be hosted on GitHub. Special shout out to Karim for suggesting this video topic. I had a lot of fun making this video and searching inside my library. If you have other suggestions for future videos, please be sure to leave them in the comments.